Prevalence, Wikipedia article audio. Prevalence in epidemiology is the proportion of a particular population found to be affected by a medical condition. It is arrived at by comparing the number of people found to have the condition with the total number of people studied, and is usually expressed as a fraction, as a percentage, or as the number of cases per 10,000 or 100,000 people. Point prevalence is the proportion of a population that has the condition at a specific point in time. Period prevalence is the proportion of a population that has the condition at some time during a given period, and includes people who already have the condition at the start of the study period as well as those who acquire it during that period. Lifetime prevalence is the proportion of a population that at some point in their life have experienced the condition. Examples and utility. Prevalence estimates are used by epidemiologists, healthcare providers, government agencies, toxicologists, and insurers. Prevalence is contrasted with incidence, which is a measure of new cases arising in a population over a given period. The difference between prevalence and incidence can be summarized thus: prevalence answers how many people have this disease right now, or how many people have had this disease during this time period. An incidence answers how many people per year newly acquire this disease. Uses. In science, prevalence describes a proportion. For example, the prevalence of obesity among American adults in 2001 was estimated by the U.S. Centers for Disease Control at approximately 20.9%. Lifetime prevalence. Prevalence is a term which means being widespread, and it is distinct from incidence. Prevalence is a measurement of all individuals affected by the disease at a particular time, whereas incidence is a measurement of the number of new individuals who contract a disease during a particular period of time. Period prevalence. To illustrate, a long-term disease that was spread widely in a community in 2002 will have a high prevalence at a given point of 2003, but it might have a low incidence rate during 2003. Conversely, a disease that is easily transmitted but has a short duration might spread widely during 2002 but is likely to have a low prevalence at any given point in 2003 but a high incidence during 2002. As such, prevalence is a useful parameter when talking about long-lasting diseases, such as HIV, but incidence is more useful when talking about diseases of short duration, such as chickenpox. Point prevalence. Lifetime prevalence is the proportion of individuals in a population that at some point in their life have experienced a case, e.g., a disease, a traumatic event, or a behavior, such as committing a crime. Often, a 12-month prevalence is provided in conjunction with lifetime prevalence. Point prevalence is the prevalence of disorder at a specific point in time. Lifetime morbid risk is the proportion of a population that might become afflicted with a given disease at any point in their lifetime. Limitations. Period prevalence is the proportion of the population with a given disease or condition over a specific period of time. It could describe how many people in a population had a cold over the cold season in 2006, for example. It is expressed as a percentage of the population and can be described by the following formula. Period prevalence equals number of cases that existed in a given period divided by number of people in the population during this period. The relationship between incidence, point prevalence, and period prevalence is easily explained via an analogy with photography. Point prevalence is akin to a flash-lit photograph, what is happening at this instant frozen in time. Period prevalence is analogous to a long exposure photograph, the number of events recorded in the photo whilst the camera's shutter was open. In a movie, each frame records an instant. By looking from frame to frame, one notices new events and can relate the number of such events to a period. See incidence rate. Point prevalence is a measure of the proportion of people in a population who have a disease or condition at a particular time, such as a particular date. It is like a snapshot of the disease in time. It can be used for statistics on the occurrence of chronic diseases. This is in contrast to period prevalence, which is a measure of the proportion of people in a population who have a disease or condition over a specific period of time, say a season, or a year. Point prevalence can be described by the formula, prevalence equals number of existing cases on a specific date divided by number of people in the population on this date. It can be said that a very small error applied over a very large number of individuals produces a relevant, non-negligible number of subjects who are incorrectly classified as having the condition or any other condition which is the object of a survey study. These subjects are the so-called false positives. Such reasoning applies to the false positive but not the false negative problem, where we have an error applied over a relatively very small number of individuals to begin with. Hence, a very high percentage of subjects who seem to have a history of a disorder at interview are false positives for such a medical condition and apparently never suffered a fully clinical syndrome. A different but related problem in evaluating the public health significance of psychiatric conditions has been highlighted by Robert Spitzer of Columbia University. Fulfillment of diagnostic criteria and the resulting diagnosis do not necessarily imply need for treatment. A well-known statistical problem arises when ascertaining rates for disorders and conditions with a relatively low population prevalence or base rate. Even assuming that lay interview diagnoses are highly accurate in terms of sensitivity and specificity and their corresponding area under the ROC curve, a condition with a relatively low prevalence or base rate is bound to yield high false positive rates, which exceed false negative rates. In such a circumstance, a limited positive predictive value, PPV, yields high false positive rates even in presence of a specificity which is very close to 100%.